Hey guys! In this video we will draw this beautiful winter scenery in Procreate. Before we start, you can download my new free lace patterns brush set and color palette we will use in the video description below. If you like these drawing tutorials, please subscribe to this channel and you can also support me on Patreon page. If you join me there, you will have access to more exclusive art tutorials and Procreate brush sets. You can find my Patreon link below too. Without further delay, let's get started! I'll be using a canvas that is 2000 by 2000 pixels. Let's begin with filling the canvas with the color that comes first in the palette. Then create a new layer and change the color into one below. I'll select monoline from calligraphy set. Make the size 13% and define a shape for the surface with a curvy line going this way. Then fill it. Now let's create a layer underneath. Grab this color at the bottom and draw an arc like this, using quick shape tool that works if you wait 1 second. Fill in this shape with the color as well. I'm going to the background layer and picking soft brush from airbrushing. Let's lower the opacity a little. I'll put the size slider somewhere in the middle and paint above the hill, just like this. After that, I will pick this dark shade and draw on top of the canvas. Let me make it full opacity. Okay, I think I will add more white color. Then apply Gaussian blur on the layer. 36.3% is fine. We can create a new layer here and pick this color from the first column. Switch back to monoline. We will draw a cute house on the hill. I'm making the brush size 1% and drawing two lines at some distance from each other for the wall. Let's also draw a roof this way. I'll connect these two lines with another line on top. And close the shape at the bottom. Then drag the color into the shape. I'm going to change the color into this one below. And draw the frontal part of the house. Let's close the shape at the bottom to be able to fill it. Now we will start adding details. I'm picking white color and monoline. Let me zoom it and create a layer above this one. I want to draw snow on the roof. It will go this way. Connecting it and filling. Let's also add some snow on the opposite side of the roof. We can see only a small part of it. And we should also fill it with the current color. I want to add some snowy texture on top. And I will be using water pen brush from Calligraphy for that. The size is at 21%. And I will just go around the edge of the white shape to add this fluffy texture looking like snow. Not pressing on the pencil. Let's create a layer above the roof. Grab this color on top and monoline brush. We will draw a chimney now, making a shape like this. Fill it. I will pick the next color right from the front wall. Draw another shape on the side. And fill it as well. And I will add some snow on top of the chimney, picking white color and water pen. The size is at 21%. And I'm drawing it like this, making circular moves. Let's create a layer for the windows here. Pick this color from the second column. Change the brush back to monoline. I'll draw a rectangular shape with a little perspective. Make sure the shape is closed and fill it. Let me duplicate this layer and clip it to the one below. I'll change its color into yellow. After that, click on the arrow and place it like this. Now let's merge these two layers and alpha lock the layer. Pick white color from the roof and water pen from brushes. I'll draw the snow on the window with a small brush size. To save some time, I will go ahead and duplicate this layer. Move it to the right. And using Distort, I will change its perspective a little to make it follow the shape of the wall. Keep in mind that when doing this, we are losing quality slightly, and it would be better if we drew this window too, but it's not critical. Well, I will pick this color again to draw one more window. Merging these layers and creating a new one. Selecting monoline and drawing a circle. I'll use my finger to make it perfect. Fill it. Now we will do all the same. Duplicate this layer and clip it. Repaint it into yellow and move to the left and down. Merge these layers and then alpha lock. pick white color and water pen brush. Let's add a little snow here too. And finally, I will draw a door. For that, I'm creating a new layer, selecting the shade and monoline. Drawing a line, another one, and a circle between them. I'll place it here, close the shape at the bottom and fill, repeating same steps as we did for the windows. But this time I'll fill the shape with this color on top and move it this way. Let's merge all the layers with details and create a layer below. I will clip it to the house layer. Go to the newest brush set with seamless patterns and grab the one that is called fishnet. I'll set the size to 24% and draw this way. Open transformation menu and use distort option. I want to make the texture parallel at least to one of the walls. Alright, I'll go to the layer and change its blending mode to overlay now. Let's merge these two layers, create a layer above and clip it. I'll color this part of the roof using monoline. And add a cast shadow on this wall under the roof. Now we can merge all layers for the house. I'm creating a new layer and picking white color from here along with water pen. Let's set the size to 33% and draw smoke going from the chimney. I'm pressing less in the beginning. Let me correct the shape a little using eraser. First erase the upper tip and then make the lower part narrowed. I think we can duplicate it and merge, just to make it less transparent. Okay, now let's create a layer on top of this one. Select this color in the first column and monoline brush. Let me clip this layer to feel more comfortable when drawing. Let's draw a footpath that goes from the door and is getting wider when it comes closer to the front heel. It will consist of two curves. I will connect edges on both sides and feel. After that, I'm going to create a layer above this one and clip it. Draw a continuation of the footpath. This time it will be easier because I'll be using quick shape feature when drawing two arcs this way. We just need to connect the invisible part on top and fill. And now let's add some shading. I will alpha lock this layer and pick soft brush. Add this color on the lower part. Then switch to white and highlight the upper part. Lower the size a little and highlight this side near the path. Also this part on top. After that I'll go to this layer and alpha lock it. Select this color on top. Increase the size and paint at the bottom. I will darken this part more using this color. Now let's lock the layer with the road so we can shade it. I will set the brush size to 4% and apply this color on the right side, starting from top until this point. Then switch to white. Increase the size a little and draw slightly on the upper part. I think I'll add more white on top of this hill. Let's add more details on the background. I'll create a new layer above it and pick snowfall seamless pattern that I added to the pattern brush set for this video only. We used this brush before, so maybe you already have it. Let's set the size to 25% and draw all over the visible part of the background without lifting the pencil up. After that, I will create a new layer above layer 6. Click on selection and pick freehand. I will make something looking like a tree or a bush shape here, consisting of tiny curves. Connect the edges. Then I'll go to brushes and pick cubic brush from the new patterns. The size of the brush is 22%. I'm painting inside the selected area without lifting the pencil. While selection is active, I'll go ahead and create a layer above. Grab studio pen from inking set. The size is at 8%. I'll draw a trunk with a few branches on the sides. Even if we try to draw outside the shape, the branches will still remain within the selection. Once we are done, we can deselect. I'll go ahead and alpha lock this layer. Pick this color and soft brush. Let's make the brush size smaller and color the trunk and branches close to the trunk. After that, we can merge these layers. I will duplicate it and move here. Flip horizontal. Let's hide the lower part of this tree by placing the layer underneath this one. I want to draw another kind of tree. For that, I will create a new layer. Go to selection again and start to create a shape. It will go down this way and then up until it meets the starting point. Now we should pick our pattern and white color. Draw in the shape. Create a new layer and grab studio pen. I'll draw a trunk in the middle, then branches on both sides of it. After that, deselect and finish drawing the trunk outside the shape. Let's merge these layers. And I'll move this tree a little down. Duplicate this layer. Move one of them to the right and flip. I will move it even more down to make it look like a bush. After that, I will change its color into this one by locking the layer and filling it. Well, now when I see it better, I think I will move it more. And flip it back. Also, I will flip the initial tree to make them still look different. Now I like how it looks. We can create a layer above all layers for the foreground. Then go to selection. And this time we will draw a third tree. Not very detailed. I'll start from here and go down, making these tiers for branches. Make it a little curvy at the bottom. And then continue going up this way until I reach the starting point. Then we should go to the palette to grab white color. And in the brushes, I will pick wavy pattern from the new set. Making the size 43% and painting over the selection without lifting the pencil till the end. Alright, now I will alpha lock it and pick this darkest color together with soft brush. I'll paint on the lower part of the tree and on top it will repeat the shape of the hills. This way we made it more noticeable. Well, after we painted the fir tree, I think I should move this tree closer to the house. Just like this. Let's decorate the fir tree a little, because it's still Christmas. I'm picking the color on the lower side and monoline, creating a layer above the fir tree. I'll make the brush size 100% and tap on the tree a few times. A couple more, and that's enough. Let's duplicate this layer, clip it, and change the color into this red on top. Alpha lock the layer and fill it. After that, click on the arrow and move the layer to the right and a little up. This way, shading all circles at once. We can merge these two and create a new layer. Set the brush size to 43% and tap a few times on this tree. These will be some berries. When these berries are ready, I'll go ahead and change the color into white. We can merge these layers just to reduce the number. And I will create a layer above the snow. We have monoline selected. I'll draw a circle here for the moon, tapping on the canvas for the perfect shape, then filling it. I think I better move it a little. Alright, now I'll duplicate it and apply Gaussian blur on the layer. Procreate doesn't show me the exact amount for some reason. This is fine. Let's just duplicate it for more shine and merge. And we will proceed to the cutest part of our winter illustration. I'll create a layer on top of all layers. Grab the thread. Set the brush size to minimum value. We will draw a bird using basic shapes. So I'll first draw a circle and fill it. This is the chest. Then I'll draw an arc on the left and another one on the right that will go this way. Fill this shape. Let's change the color into black and create a layer above. We will draw a wing same way. First make an oval. And then continue the shape at the bottom like this. Also fill it. We can totally draw the tail on the same layer. Here comes a line and another one with a small angle. At the bottom, I will connect them with a curve. Drag the color inside. To draw the head, I will create a layer underneath this red one. This time I'm not using quick shape tool, just drawing a curve this way. connecting it at the bottom and filling with black color. Now let me pick white to draw the eye. I'll make the size 8% and tap somewhere here. With the same color we will draw the beak, but on a separate layer that I'll create above the head. Let me make the brush size low again. Drawing a line, another one, and two more on the opposite side that are shorter. Painting inside. Let's alpha lock the layer and pick this color together with a soft brush. I will make it low size and shade the upper edge. At the bottom, I will shade the entire lower part of the beak. Well, now I want to rearrange something here. First, I'll change the head shape a bit. Using monoline. And eraser. And I'm also not quite satisfied with the eye. Let me paint it over with black. Then select white again. And I'll tap a little upper than it was. Now it's better. Let's add some color variation on the body. I will first create a layer above it. Go to the layer and click select. Back on the new layer to draw an arc at the bottom, this way. Fill in this shape. Now we can deselect and alpha lock this layer. Select this dark color and soft brush. Let's shade the lower part of this shape. After that, go to the base layer and also lock it. I'll grab yellow from the color palette, lower the opacity and draw here slightly. Then pick this red below, get the opacity back to 100% and draw the shadow under the wing. Finally, let's create a new layer, go to the layer with the wing and get it selected. And pick white color. Change the brush into monoline. I'll draw an arc. Edit it a little. And fill the area above it. Create one more layer. Change the color into this one. Draw an arc above. You can also edit it if needed. And drop the color inside the shape. We did it all on separate layers to be able to shade each part separately. So now we can alpha lock this layer. Grab white color and soft brush. I will draw on the lower part. Let me check it. Okay, I will change the shape of the beak. And I will be doing it using distortion. I'll just drag some of the dots to make it a bit smaller. It's done. The bird looks cute. I will merge all layers for the bird and duplicate. Let's place one of the birds on this tree. I will flip it, rotate, and make it a little smaller. Okay, this bird is at its place. Let's do the other one. I will also rotate it, as if there is something to eat on the ground. And I will make it smaller. It would be more correct if we kept this bird a little bigger. But I will keep the harmony of the drawing if I make them same size. Let's find the best place for it. And deselect. I will pick red color from the lower side and create a new layer. Select monoline brush and set its size to 43%. I'll tap a few times. Then duplicate this layer and clip. Pick this red on top, lock the layer and click Fill. Using arrow, move this layer a little to the right and up. Then duplicate the initial layer, lock it and repaint it into this dark color. Let's unlock it now and move this way to create a shadow. And we can blur it just a tiny bit using Gaussian blur. Well, I think I can move it a bit. Since these berries have a shadow, the bird should have it too. For that, I will create a new layer under the bird and pick soft brush. Make the size 2% and draw this way. Our winter composition is ready. I used this color palette and no textures so far to boost your creativity a little. I always love when you add your own stuff to my tutorials. That is my main purpose. Not only to show all the possibilities of Procreate and its cool features, but also inspire you to do your own creative stuff. So now I'll show a few options how to make a drawing look cool and pretty. First, I will pick white color and create a layer above all layers. I'm going to Sketching to select Artist Crayon brush. The size is at 17%. And I'm going all over the canvas, not pressing too much. Of course, we can't keep it like this, it's too white. What we can do is change the layer's blending mode to overlay and reduce the opacity. 39% is fine. Looks better already, but it's not complete yet. I'll add a bit more texture here. After we apply the texture, we can see what colors we need to fix. For example, I will add more white here, using soft brush. This one was a bit too dark as well. Okay, now I'll make sure I'm on top layer. Open Actions menu and in the Add section, click Copy Canvas. Then open it again and click Paste. Now we have everything in one layer and can start experimenting with colors. And there are a few options for that. First one is to apply one of the presets from the gradient map. Or even create your own gradient scheme. Another option is to change hue, saturation and brightness. I will try color balance. In the first bar, I will move the slider to the cyan. Here, I will move it towards magenta slightly. And finally, I'll move the yellow one just a tiny bit. A little more magenta. And this is exactly what I like. I think when using this feature, we are getting these midtones and effect that we can hardly achieve simply using the color palette. You can continue experimenting. For instance, there is noise texture that can be applied on the layer. It has a few options, and each of them has different settings. Just see if you like any of those. So it can look like this. I will cancel it for now, and I will consider my drawing complete. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. Also, tag me if you share on Instagram, so I'll be able to see your post. You can support me and unlock more in-depth tutorials on my Patreon. The link to my Patreon page is in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon!